On today's episode of Hootworthy, I got to talk to Ellie and Arwen. They both participated in GCA's Social Studies and Science Fair. Ellie won the science portion, while Arwen won the social studies portion. We discussed their projects and their experiences at the fair. Enjoy the show. I have Ellie and Arwen here, and y'all are on Hootworthy because you won GCA's Science and Social Studies Fair. Ellie, you won the science portion, and Arwen, you won the social studies portion.
Correct.
Thanks for coming on the show. Thanks for being here. But before we dive in, if you could learn any skill overnight, what would you pick? And Ellie, you start.
If I had to learn any skill, I would definitely love to be a speed reader. If that's a skill I could learn,
yeah,
definitely be that one.
Speed reader. Yes. What would be like the, is there a words per minute on speed reading? Or is it like you can do a whole book in a day? Like, what is that? And you just totally understand everything?
Yes,
in the book
mainly. I would love to understand it and read it as fast as you can.
That's awesome.
Yes.
That would be a superpower.
Yeah, for sure.
It's a great skill. What about you, Arwen? What would you pick?
I would say sewing, just because I like fashion a lot. So I think it'd be kind of cool to make your own clothes. And then also I like dressing up like for Halloween and stuff. So I think it'd be kind of cool to like cosplay and make your own costumes.
Yeah.
So.
Right on. That's cool. My skill wouldn't be nearly as cool as that. So I don't want to get embarrassed. So what initially sparked your interest in even participating in this fair? Why don't you start with me, Arwen? Like, why did you even want to do the social studies fair to begin with?
So I'd never done anything like that before. So I thought it'd be really cool to share something that I'm passionate about and have the experience to do something part of GCA. So that was really my interest.
Cool. And how did you learn about it? Did you have someone tell you about it, or was there like a flyer or something? How'd you even know that?
It was mainly our teachers. We were required to at least just do the assignment, but then we could be chosen by them, or we had the option to be entered into the fair based on whether they chose us or not.
Oh, right on. What about you, Ellie? Why'd you want to do it? What sparked your interest?
Well, actually, my science teacher, she showed us videos for science experiments that we could do, since it was kind of a mandatory thing we had to do for class. And she showed us videos of these really cool science projects, and the electromagnet train, what I did was a 3-second blip in it, and I was like, ooh, this is kind of interesting, you know?
Oh, neat. What, now, was that video they shared, was that like GCA student videos, or was it just a...
It was a random online video she showed us.
Okay, neat. So, let's talk a little bit about your project. So, Ellie, can you tell me, you mentioned electromagnet, that train, that's what you did. So can you give me like a big picture? Can you describe for us like what your project was? Like, what were you trying to solve or whatever?
Okay, so my main goal was to figure out if the weight of the battery, which is part of the train, if the weight of the battery, if you changed it out, would it affect the speed of it completing the track? So I had to create the track, which was the copper coils, and then the battery with the two magnets on each end was considered the train part. So you stick it on one end of the copper coil, and you place it in there, you let it go, you start your timer, and you let it complete the course. And you stop the timer, obviously, at the end, and you average your speed after multiple attempts. And that's how I really did my project, was testing the differences of the weights of the battery. So I used a Duracell battery, which was about double the weight of an E-circuit battery. And I found out my results were counterintuitive, and the lighter battery didn't go faster than the Duracell, which was heavier.
So you thought that the lighter battery would complete the track quicker.
Yes, I did.
Than the heavier battery.
Yes, I did.
But it turns out the heavier battery.
It did. It was due to the internal resistance.
Ah, and so you went with Duracell.
Yeah.
So your project was sponsored by Duracell.
I guess so.
Not Energizer.
Yeah.
Okay, so, well, that That makes a lot of sense, Ellie. So what about you, Arwen? Can you describe your project for us? Like what did you set out to learn or discover in social studies?
Well, I did mine on World War I. And for me, I just find it very fascinating, the whole war, everything that went into it. So basically, I just wanted to really just share some of the things I had learned and just like doing stuff like over the summer, like research I had done. I just wanted people to kind of learn more about the war because I feel like World War II is talked more about. Mm-hmm. So I basically just wanted to share some things that maybe people didn't realize and just, you know, kind of open or broaden their horizon a bit and maybe, you know, give them something maybe that they would want to research too. Mm-hmm.
And what impacts did you figure out that World War I had?
So the main one I would definitely say is warfare technology, which, you know, obviously to this day we're still using some of the same technology. The next one would be medical practices, and then I also focused on altering geography and then some of the conflicts that it sort of War I contributed to.
Okay. So those the warfare technology, can you tell me a little bit of the findings that you had with that?
Yeah. So I'd say the main one, of course, is mustard gas. That one really became, you know, widely used during this time. It actually led to gas being banned afterwards because of how horrible it was. So even World War II, they didn't use it. Also, planes and tanks were both introduced during this time. And then you even had the use of submarines as well. So, and then also during this time, trench warfare came into use as well because of the machine guns that were being used. So.
Oh, wow. The introduction of that. Yeah. And the medical practices, what sort of impacts were those? Did you discover? Do you remember?
So one of the things I remember was they started doing blood transfusions more. And then there was something, this was just kind of a fun fact that I found, but basically there was a company called Cellucotton that created these like, cotton bandage things that were basically used as filters for gas masks, but now they've been turned into tissues. So we use them, you know, during allergies, and I just found that like kind of ironic.
Sure.
Yeah.
Wow. So I got a better idea about y'all's project. We got a big picture idea and y'all's different topics. Can you tell me about the actual day of the fair? So it was one day, right?
Right.
Y'all weren't there multiple days. Can you tell me about like what it was like start to finish? Maybe arriving, setting up your project. Was it like social studies on one side and science on the other side? Where were you? How many people were there? Kind of, if nobody went to the science and social studies fair, how would you describe it to them? And y'all can tag team this thing if you want to kind of go a little bit, if you think of something, but y'all were both there. You did the science thing. You did the social studies thing, but kind of describe, and Ellie, you can kind of start kind of like, give us an idea of what the actual fair was like.
So when you enter the Telos Museum, you kind of get an idea of what everything looks like. You can obviously see where the different kind of stations are of after you give your science experiment or your history poster and stuff. You can see that there's the rocks and minerals section, the dinosaur bones, and a little bit more of a educational history section. And then they direct you towards an area where all of our posters would be set up. And they did have it divided with history and the science. And they had different colored tablecloths. So the science would go on, was it blue for y'all or was it green?
Oh, I can't remember. I just remember it seemed like social studies projects were mainly in the front and then science were mainly in the back. That's all I remember.
Yeah, sure. And did they have judges coming around to each table?
Yes. Yeah.
The judges kind of sporadically went. It wasn't like all judges were at you at one time. Yeah. I kind of liked how they had them kind of at different stations all at once because it made me feel a lot less nervous.
Yeah.
Because you kind of were just talking, there was talking around you. So it wasn't all the attention wasn't on you. So that helped a lot.
And to kind of add to that, I would say when we first set up our projects, we had about like 40 minutes, or at least I did, to kind of wait before other people came. So I noticed like some of the kids, if they had their project set up, their parents would go around and visit everyone else so that you could kind of like sort of practice talking to the parents and stuff. And it was kind of cool because when the judges came around, it made it just seem a bit more homey and not like a lot of pressure on you because it's just kind of like you're talking to like a friend or, you know, your parent or something. So yeah, it was a lot more less stressful than I thought it would be, I would say.
Yes.
Did y'all know anyone that participated before you went? Were you able to interact with the people around you, the other did y'all meet any students? Tell me a little bit about that at the fair, that environment.
Yeah, so I would say I didn't really know anyone. Well, there were several classmates, especially from my world literature honors class, but I had no clue that they were there. So it wasn't until I started talking to them and then we started making the connections, like, oh, we're all in the same class. Mm. But otherwise, I didn't know anyone. So it was like the first time getting to meet other GCA students, which was really cool.
Oh, that is cool.
So my physics honors teacher was there, Ms. Bolke. So she's the one who helped me get to that point. So she was actually there. And my classmate who won second place, Ezekiel, was there too.
Oh, cool.
So I got to see them.
Well, y'all tell me a little bit about completing. What was the process like of completing your project? Like, how long did it take you a little bit kind of start to finish? I know y'all kind of described your purpose and major point of it, but tell me a little bit about your process of start to finish getting your project from like, I have nothing to, oh, I have this completed thing. How long did that take and what was that like? You can start on.
Okay, so for me, when I first did it back in the fall for the main project that you're required to do anyway, it took me about, I would say, 2 or 3 weeks just to get all my research together and then put and create like a Google presentation with it. Mm. And I had to go and like find images. I'm also very perfectionistic, so I was like, you know, really went top with the creativity. So when it came to actually making the project for the fair, basically what I did was I just printed out all my slides. And then my grandma had this really cool idea, which is where we burned the edges around the paper to make it look warlike,
yeah,
sort of.
Yeah.
And then I put it on a poster board. So really it was kind of simple for me when it came to making the actual project for the fair.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Cool. What about you, Ellie?
So, well, when I started from nothing, I had the idea of the electromagnet train, but I wasn't sure if I had all the materials because I had specially ordered the magnets to fit the AA battery. And so I had to make sure I had a hypothesis, something that would work. So I had to find that independent, dependent variable and what I would change. So definitely the weight of the battery was probably the easiest. So that's what I went with. And so, yeah, it was pretty simple, like Arwen said. After you did the project in the fall, it was easy when we had to make the poster and stuff because all you really had to do was print it out and design the poster how you wanted it. So it was real nice.
Right on. Well, tell me about the moment you found out you won. So you're at the fair, right? What went through your mind? How did that even come? Did they like announce it up at a podium? Did they just come around and tell you? Like, tell me about that. What were you thinking? What were you feeling the moment they announced it, Ellie?
So they had us all come in after we visited the Telus Museum, how we kind of walked around for like an hour and we got to eat lunch. So we went back in and we met a certain time and they had chairs set out for us to all sit in. So they had someone up at the podium and then they announced the winners and stuff. So they had third, second, then first for each four divisions of two sciences and then the two history. And honestly, when they called my name, I was shocked. but I was also honored, but still shocked because there were so many other good projects around me. Mm-hmm. I didn't think I was going to win.
And they called you up? And you went up, got your
yeah,
award.
Yeah, it was in front of the podium.
Cool, got the award and did a big speech.
Yeah, no.
No.
Right. Arwen, what about you? What were you thinking, feeling?
Pretty
you
much,
said you were pretty much.
Okay. Yeah, I would say, yeah, I remember, I honestly did not think I didn't really even think I was going to get even third place because like she said, there were so many cool projects in both categories.
Mm-hmm.
And so it wasn't until the very last second that I had this very weird feeling that maybe I had won. Because they did it where they announced third place, then second place, and then first place. So it was like a mystery. Everybody was like, oh, who's going to win?
Sure.
So when they announced my name, I was shaking terribly. Like, you can probably see my hands. I mean, I was terrible. But I was so shocked. But it was a really cool moment, for
awesome.
Sure.
Awesome. Mm-hmm. So what kind of advice would y'all give to students who are going to be participating in the Social Studies Science Fair? What would you tell them if you could give them, like, one piece of advice or something if they were getting in there? What would you say, Arwen?
I would definitely say try not to overthink it. Like, definitely just look at it as like a really fun memory that you're going to look back on. Like, in your 20s and your 30s and think, oh yeah, I did that. And it's not stressful. The judges are really kind. You know, you get to meet other classmates. So I think just try to enjoy it. Mm-hmm. Like, really just have fun sharing something that you're passionate about and just don't stress about it.
Mm, that's awesome.
I definitely say if you do especially a science project, get creative with it and make sure it has a lot of originality. So a lot of science experiments that I see kids do, they've seen a lot of people already have done it before, so you can already know what's going to happen. Awesome. But in my project, no one's really ever done it before. Mm. Only a few certain people have. So that's why my hypothesis was wrong.
sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Well, that's good.
Yeah.
You got to test it.
Yeah, it's good. So it's really good to focus on originality and making it unique compared to others.
I would definitely agree with that.
Mm-hmm. Right on. So beyond winning, obviously, what do y'all think was the most rewarding thing about participating in this science and social studies fair? What would you say, Ellie?
It was definitely meeting all my peers and my teachers and stuff. I really enjoyed it, and going to the TELUS Museum, it was a lot of fun.
That's awesome.
I definitely agree with her. Meeting other people was really cool because even though, you know, obviously we have milestones testing, so you do go in person and you might have a chance to meet someone. This was really the first time I actually had the chance to really talk and meet other classmates.
Yeah.
So for me, that was a really big, cool thing.
That's awesome. That's awesome. It is great. So what do you enjoy about being a student at GCA? What would you say, Arwen? What do you enjoy about it?
Gosh, I'd say definitely being able to just, you know, do school from home, be relaxed, not have the pressure of like other people judging you or like any of like drama, anything. Just be able to focus on like learning stuff, getting your assignments done. And also I think it's cool because like sometimes my little cousins have gotten to watch me in my classes.
Ah.
And like my oldest cousin, his name's Rowan, he's in preschool. So he's gotten to see me in some of my classes and he loves that. So it's been really cool to just be at home, be able to hang out with family, but still focus on my education.
And love it.
Yeah, I would definitely say that.
Love it. Love it. What about you, Ellie?
I like how the classes, they have a lot of varieties, electives and classes, and how the teachers kind of help you. If you're struggling with something, they'll make sure like on win days and stuff that you understand the curriculum that a lot of students may struggle with. And I like how they have honors classes and stuff. Mm-hmm. It's really great. They have a lot of resources.
Right on. So before you guys head out of here, any shout outs you want to give? Arwen, you got any shout outs you want to give before you head out?
Yeah, definitely. I want to shout out to all my teachers and all my classmates. They've been amazing. Honestly, I think that's what makes GCA so amazing is the teachers and the classmates. I don't think you can really find that in a lot of public schools. The teachers especially, they are amazing. And they're always very hands-on. You know, if you ever need them, you know, you can just send them an email. They're usually very quick to respond.
Mm-hmm.
And they always want to make sure that, you know, you understand everything, you're doing well. If you're ever stressed, you know, they help you with it. So definitely the teachers I want to shout out to.
Right on. Best teachers around. What about you, Ellie?
I'll give a shout out to my parents. They were a huge supporter in me getting this far. And my teachers for sure, especially my science one, Ms. Bolke, and my classmates and peers, they were a huge encouragement too.
Awesome. Awesome. Well, Ellie and Arwen, thanks again so much for coming on the show, for being Hootworthy. You know, congrats again on winning this first place science for Ellie and social studies for Arwen. But hey, stay Hootworthy. We'll catch you later. And do the science and social studies fair. Don't miss out.